What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about deploying Windows 11 within your SCCM. So let's get right into it. Okay, so today is all about importing and pushing out Windows 11 within your SCCM. Now, the version of SCCM that I'm running within my testing lab is 2107, all right? So let's get right into it. So the first thing that we need to do is go inside this website. I will place these links at the bottom at the description part of the video, so don't freak out. And once you're here, we're going to locate the part where it says download Windows 11 disk image, and we're going to click on the drop down menu and pick Windows 11 and then click on download. It's going to take you here. We need to click on the drop down menu to pick our language. Once you pick your language, we are going to pick on confirm. It's going to take you here. From here, we are going to click on 64-bit download. Once you do that, it's going to download the ISO file. Now, because I'm using Internet Explorer, I need to save it. So I'm going to click on that arrow and click on Save As. And I'm going to drop my ISO within the Downloads folder. So click on Save. Now, once it's done, we are going to open up that folder. And there goes our Windows 11 64-bit ISO file. It is around 5.12 gigs, so it's a pretty huge file. Now, the next thing that we're going to do is right-click on the file, and we are going to mount it. Now, once we mount it, we need to copy these files locally into our SCCM server. Now, I already created a folder called Windows 11 x64, and it's actually located within my SCCM server, sources, OSD, OS, OS images, and Windows 11 x64. So what I'm going to do is basically copy and paste all those files inside that folder, okay? Once we're done, the next thing that we need to do is double check and make sure you are running the latest and greatest Windows ADK. Now, the one that I have within my SCCM server is version 19.0.4.1, and that's not the latest one. So what we need to do is download the latest one that's going to support Windows 11. So I will provide the link for you guys to go directly here. And what we need to do is download the Windows ADK and the Windows PE. And once that's done, it depends on where you dropped it. For me, I dropped it inside the downloads folder, and there it goes. Now, one of the things I do not like about ADK is that you have to manually uninstall what you have within your server. So go inside Control Panel, pick your Windows PE, click on uninstall, click yes here, and it's going to start uninstalling those features. And you're going to do the same thing with your Windows ADK. Select it, click uninstall, click yes, it's going to remove it. And once it's removed within your server, go back inside that downloads folder or wherever you downloaded those new Windows 11 ADK files, and we need to, you know, install it. So the first one I like to install is the Windows ADK one. So select it, right click on it, run it as an administrator. Pretty self-explanatory here. So click next here. It really depends on what you choose. Once you pick it, click next, accept the license and terms. I left everything as the default and just click on install. Once it's done, you're going to get this and then close it. Now go back inside that folder where you downloaded those files, select your Windows PE, right click on it, run it as administrator. Again, follow the steps, click next here, pick your option here. Once you pick it, click next, accept the license and terms. You only have one thing to install within your Windows PE installation, so click on install. It's going to start installing your features. Once it's done, you're going to get this, so close it. Now, once you go inside your control panel, you're going to see that you are running the latest Windows ADK, which is actually version 22000. Now, open up your SCCM console. I'm going to show you guys which version I'm using. So I'm going to click on the File tab. I'm going to go to About Configuration Manager, and I'm currently running version 2107. So version 2107 is one of the core requirements to actually have Windows 11 deploy successfully within your SCCM server. So make sure you're running the latest version, okay? So the next thing that we need to do is go inside software. Within software, we're going to go inside operating systems. And within the operating system, we are going to select the operating system images. We're going to right click on that node and click on add operating system image. Then we need to browse to that UNC path of where we copied and pasted those files into. So click on browse, and I'm going to go inside that Windows 11 64 folder that we created, And remember, I copied and pasted all the stuff within that ISO inside this folder. So we need to go inside sources and locate that install.win file. Once you locate it, click on open. Now, the next thing that we need to do is give a check mark where it says, by checking the box, you are agreeing that when applying this image to a device, blah, blah, blah. So just make sure you check that off. Next thing that we need to do is check off extract a specific image index. Click on that drop-down menu and then pick your Windows poison, right? For me, I am going to deploy number 4, index 4, which is Windows 10 Education. And I'm going to click on next. Pick your flavor, 86 or 64-bit. Click on the drop-down menu and then pick your language. Once you're done, click on next. From here, you're going to give your system image a name, a version, a comment. Once you're done, click on next. You're going to get a nice little summary. Next here, it's going to start exporting that single image inside your SCCM server. Once it's completed, you get all green check marks, which is a good thing, and then close it. Now, next thing that we need to do from here is we need to select our system image, right click on it, and we're going to distribute the content. We're going to click next here. We're going to click on add, and we're going to pick DP and then pick your DP. Once you pick your DP, click OK. Click on next. You're going to get a nice little summary, so click on next. Once it's done, you're going to get a green check mark, completed successfully, and then close it. Now from here, before I continue, I like to wait until the content status basically says in progress. And I wait even more until it says success. Once I get that green check mark, it basically means I could continue. So the next thing that we need to do is go inside our task sequence node. We're going to right click on it and click on create a task sequence. Now within a create a new task sequence, I'm going to leave the default, which is install an existing image package. You're going to give your task sequence a name and then click on browse. And then you're going to pick your boot image. Once you pick your boot image, we're going to click on next. And then it's time for us to pick your image package. And we're going to click on browse. Now it's time for us to pick our image package. So select it and then okay it. Now next thing that I like to do is enable the administrative password, provide a password and confirm it. Make sure you make any other changes within this dialog box. Once you're done, click on next. If you're joining a work group or a domain, make sure you configure it and then click on next. For your configuration manager client, this is up to you. Once you're done, click on next. If you're doing any state migration, configure it here. Once you're done, click on next. If you're pushing out updates, make sure you configure it. Next again. If you're installing apps, you know, configure it within your environment and then click next. A nice little summary. Click next here. It's going to start doing its magic. Once it's done, you should get this, which is a good thing. And then just basically close it. Now, next thing that we need to do is deploy our task sequence. Now, we're going to select our task sequence, right click on it, and then click on deploy. I'm going to click on browse to pick my collection. You're going to get a warning. Just click OK and then pick your collection. Now, for my collection, I'm going to pick all unknown computers because I want to distribute it throughout a Pixie environment. Once you're done, click OK, click next. Now from here, it really depends on how you're deploying it. For me, I'm going to do it within a Pixie environment. So I'm going to click on that drop down menu and then pick only media in Pixie and then click on next. For scheduling, left it as the default, click next. For user experience, default, next. Alerts, default, next. For the DP section, I didn't touch anything, default. Click next, a nice little summary, next. It's gonna start doing its magic. Now, once everything is done, you're going to get green check marks and then you're able to close it. And that's it. Now, don't go anywhere because at the end of the video, you're going to see a speed video of the task sequence actually being pushed out to a virtual machine. And it worked out with no problem. I was super happy about it. And hopefully you guys enjoy and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.